Hi there, out in the rain, enjoying a beautiful West Texas day when it looks more like Louisiana than West Texas. So, we've got a lot of things to discuss on the show today, one of which is, God, one of the most interesting and talented young men I've ever met. He is really a rising rap star that speaks to the heart of this generation. We're going to introduce you to Israel coming up. Also, my daughter stopping by to give us her thoughts and just kind of share the afternoon with her dad. Firearms. I'm going to tell you about the number one thing you can do to prevent a malfunction on your firearm at the range. And I'm seeing this a lot lately with new firearms owners. You're going to want to stick around for that one. And speaking of firearms, gun bags, have you priced them lately? They are not cheap, but I can show you how to make a hardened plastic gun bag of your very own for under 50 bucks. And it's not this big, right? We'll talk about those things and more coming up on the Spencer Bennett All-American Radio Show.
Thank you so much for this beautiful day you've given us. I ask blessings on the teens of our town, that they would know Jesus and that they would love one another and that they would be encouraged to grow in their faith. So bless our youth and bless them good in the powerful name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Why are you here tonight?
Well, I work with a group called Cut the Cutting. Cut the Cutting is a group that we try and pull teens away from suicides, bullying, cutting, and teen pregnancies. And we're working with them, going through social media and doing like interviews with the news, and we are holding like lock-ins and all these different things to try and get them to come to us instead of staying around all the bad influences in Andrews.
I should have cleaned it.
Well, tonight is all about bringing kids together and giving them a voice. You know, Greg Griffin, who made history in Andrews, bringing the great concerts, Mercy Me, Newsboys, Switchfoot, every big name in the Christian music pretty much, is taking it a step further. Now there's monthly events for the teenagers in and around Andrews. And of course, you know, I've said it many, many times before that there's a race to the heart of your child, and the one who gets their first wins. We're wanting to get there first. So we're going to bring them together, be able to get their information, to be in contact with them, and make sure that everyone either has an option to have a church home or to be involved in some type of group. But at the end of the day, we're wanting to make disciples. We're also wanting to provide discipleship opportunities. And even to the world, as a city on the hill, we want to make ideal citizens, because if you don't invest in this generation, we've got a lot of trouble. So we're excited about this generation, and we want to celebrate them. This is a very diverse crowd coming tonight, and I only expected to see it increase as time goes along. So we're excited.
God is my everything. He's my father and my guidance and everything like that, and so he's everything. And I think it's good to go to things like this to help other people learn about God who don't know God.
What's happening here tonight for you?
I came out to listen to an amazing rapper that I heard of.
I always knew, I'm saying I knew about God, but you know, but didn't know, really know the power of God until, you know, he took a hold of me. Understood it, shining bright like night lights. See my name, face in the bright lights. I fought and struggled with God. I struggled and fought with church folks, you know, and it was just the journey that I had to take in life, you know, doing shows, you know, in the music industry, you know, been around like with the Pretty Rickies, the Marcus Houston and Charlie Boys, and you know, just living life wild out there, you know, like the women, the drugs, you know, and you know, being out there, you see everything, you know, the bad and the good, but you know, mostly it's the bad, you know, from club to club, city to city, state to state. The wrong roads that I took and how I survived to come through that is just to teach them and show them, hey, you know, this is the wrong route to take. Let me show you the positive route to take. And just showing them through, just not through music, but just showing them through my words and teachings that I learned through my paths. it's like you choose and pick on what you want, you know what I'm saying? And my choice was, you know, like to do wrong. And like my testimony, you know, it starts back, you know, when I had, I'm saying, having a car wreck, you know, being recruited by, heavily recruited, my junior year of high school, coming and having a car wreck, coming out of a coma. I'm saying it was brain dead. I'm saying pronounced dead for several minutes. Coming back, I'm saying coming out of a coma and not being able to play basketball no more. So I run the streets, you know, gang activity. I'm saying drug selling. I'm saying grand theft auto. You know, anything you need. Been through jail, and it's just, I'm saying, carrying guns. I'm saying trying to commit homicide. I'm saying I had thoughts of suicide, trying to commit suicide.
Briefly dead in a car crash at the age of 17. He was in a coma for 20 days, and the doctors told his mother he would have to relearn how to walk, relearn how to talk. He not only emerged learning how to walk and talk, but he emerged out of this coma with an incredible, unusually brilliant gift of being a poet, a wordsmith, and a music producer. And he's here tonight, none other than the rapper Israel.
It's time for everybody to start coming together instead of being separated, you know. And it's, I'm saying, it's a community deal. It's about more like the youth, I'm saying, because, you know, who's going to take over next? And it's the time for the generation of the youth to come up. So I think this is just a good time, just everybody just come back and just give back and just having a good day today.
What's the Lord saying to you?
Well, you know, it's just really, it's like letting this will be done, and, you know, just giving back to the community here in Andrews. You know, it's a lot of teens down here, you know, they lost and they searching, you know, and it's just a good opportunity that I was given to come down here, you know, to share my testimony about my life, you know, my trials and tribulations outside when I was in the world and industry, and I'm saying, and now I'm back, you know, giving back, I'm saying, to every community that I touch, and all to the youth, and it's just a great time, and I just thank God for it. With God, it's nothing you can't do. You know what I'm saying? I'm living proof about it, you know. Anything that you go through, he can see you through it.
Pushed in the corner, fight the best fight. Never blinded by words, my eyesight. Beautiful bride, the music, I'm the groom. Speaking words to wire.
And you know, most people talk about the street life, and really they never really seen the street life. I've been in the street life. Guns, drugs, stealing cars, jail. Anything you name it. And like I'm saying, I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm not going to hold nothing from you. And like the songs I got from you right now, just little snippets and samples, a little stuff that's coming from my album pretty soon. It's coming out.
But you know, with God, it's nothing you can't do. And I'm saying, I'm living proof about it, you know. Anything that you go through, he can see you through it. And I used to look at it like now, I look at it like a movie. What happens to the good guy that everybody knows in the movie? At the end, what? He wins. Same thing about God. At the end, he wins. Even though you're going through a struggle in your life right now, don't worry about it, because at the end, if you keep focusing on the faith, you will always win. And that's God's word.
Hope you enjoy.
Brant, we sat down at breakfast one morning and he shared his story with me. What a passionate young man who has a heart to speak to this generation. God gave him his life back to share that life with so many others, and we're going to look for some good things coming with Israel. All right, coming up next, we're going to be talking about firearms and a special event to honor those fallen officers in Dallas. We'll tell you all about that coming up next.
You're invited to the Back the Blue Block Party at the Rock the Desert Complex, Saturday, October 1st from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. with free admission to the public. There'll be food, jumpers, face painting, the Paw Patrol, and the coolest response vehicles. Don't miss the car show and bring a healthy appetite, because we've got $5 hot dog combo plates from 11 to 1. Come celebrate and support with Midland and Odessa law enforcement agencies. Bring a lawn chair and enjoy local country bands. Bring your cash donations, because it's all to benefit the Dallas police and DART officers' families involved in the terrorist attack in Dallas. The Back the Blue Block Party at the Rock the Desert Complex, October 1st, from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Don't miss it.
All right, so we're back in the house, out of the rain, and at the range, what I'm seeing a lot of right now are people who bring in a new firearm, and after shooting a few hundred rounds through it, or maybe even not 100 rounds, they start to say, well, and my firearm's jamming up. I'm really seeing some stovepiping. I'm seeing failure to eject properly, it's not loading the next round well, or it's just not coming all the way back and not picking up the next round or ejecting properly. The problem is this. There's not enough lube on the gun. Right, I know. A lot of people think they just put a couple of drops and that's it. That's really going to burn off pretty quickly depending on the lube that you've got. What I'm seeing are people coming in with dry firearms and then they're wondering what's going on. If it's rough, if you're seeing a lot of like sandpaper movement, a lot rougher than when you originally bought the handgun, that could be part of your problem. You're just starting to feel it, and if it's really jerky. Now, a Glock's not going to be hand-finished like a Kimber will be. A Kimber, a Dan Wesson, things like that, you're going to be able to feel the smoothness, and that shouldn't be rough like a more inexpensive gun. Let's just put it that way. I'm not going to name any brands, but I'm just going to say, and it's not Glock. Glock's a great gun, but I'm just saying you'll feel it. You'll feel the slide, the motion. By the way, this is not loaded. There is no magazine in the firearm. But here's the deal. You've got to put oil on these things. You've got to lube them up good, and I'm going to show you how to lube your Glock right now. All right, we're going to do a short takedown of the Glock 19 right quick. And I'll show you the areas on this particular one that you need to lube. All right, so I've got the Glock disassembled right here. You can see that this barrel looks pretty wet. I oiled this up pretty well. And then the inside of the gun, there are certain specific places right here inside the frame where the barrel rubs, on the rails, and this particular piece of metal right here. You see that? Yep, Glock wants you to put some oil on that, but not down here and not in where the striker is hitting. You leave those areas dry, okay? Put your barrel back in, put some oil on the spring if you want to. I do, and then there's four places on this frame where metal are touching that you want to put oil. Here, here, and then on the other side here, and here. And then put your gun back together. Make sure you don't have any ammo around you while you're doing this, but make sure you've got plenty of oil. You know, you can use whatever you want. There's some good stuff out there. The Hoppies, the CLP. I don't have every single brand here. And I'm trying out some of this new muscle firepower that was dropped off at the office for free. I just really like this stuff. I don't know. I've got to find out more about it, but I've got the gun coated in it. I'm going to shoot a few hundred rounds through it and see how it holds up. And when it does, I'll let you know. And that right there is an important way to make sure your firearm is lubed up and will keep you protected. Keep it clean, keep it lubed, and make sure that you don't have any solvent in this barrel. You don't want any solvent or oil inside that chamber. Keep that thing dry inside the tube. Why? Because solvent and oils can get into the round. They can penetrate the round. It can misfire. The primer could not go off. Things, bad things happen when a round is exposed to a lot of solvent and oil. So keep your rounds clean and dry, your barrel clean and dry, and the rest of your gun lubed up and clean and ready to function, because your life may depend on it.
While I'm waiting on my daughter to show up in just a few minutes, I want to tell you about a way that I've discovered to protect your firearms for a little bit of money, which is great, because if you've ever priced out a Pelican case, they're not cheap. Yeah, they're great. They really are. Don't get me wrong. But who has $150, $160 bucks they can throw down on a plastic case to protect their firearms? Some of us just want to buy ammunition right now, right? So I'm going to show you how to build your very own hardened plastic gun case for under $50 bucks.
All right, let's talk about guns and how to transport them to and from the range. You want a good bag. This one I've received from the Glock Shooting Sports Foundation. It is beautiful. It is a beautiful Pelican case, as a matter of fact, I believe. And a lot of the cases are by Pelican are manufactured like this. Very sturdy, very tough, great material on the inside that you can pick out to the shape of your gun, basically, and store your magazines, your gun in here. Great way to travel, especially if you're flying. You can lock it up, make sure it's TSA approved, obviously. And it's even got a little vent that you can make it breathe, adjust the air pressure to get the thing open if you travel to different altitudes. So, great option. Pelican bags, very expensive, very expensive. Great, they do their job. But what if you don't want to spend hundreds of dollars on a hard case for your firearms, but you still want to transport them and still get them to the range in one piece? My advice is to go to your local hardware store and get something like this. I went down to my local hardware store and got one of these hard cases for a tool, and it's been fantastic. Got my thermal gun here, just in case I want to see the temperature of the barrel. Keep extra batteries here. Each one of these compartments is great because this area right here keeps everything in its particular container. So I've got 40 rounds, 45 rounds here. I've got 10 millimeter here. I've got 9 millimeter over here. So nothing gets mixed up. Everything stays in its own place. Extra batteries, like I said, for my hearing protection. Got some earplugs over here. And just, you can take these out if you need to, which is really, really kind of handy. And you can see everything is really modular. So, I mean, if you have several guns you want to put in, just leave one tray here, you can do that. I just think this is the way to go a lot of times if you don't want to spend hundreds of dollars on a hard case. Now, you'll see it's got a rubber seal around it right here. Rubber seal keeps out water and moisture and things like that. Is it waterproof? I'm not going to go throw this in a pool to find out, but I would say that it's water resistant up to a point. Now, I have filled the bottom with some of this foam that you find at any fabric store. Now, yeah, I know it's a cheap way to go. You can buy the more expensive foam, but we're building something under 50 bucks here that normally would cost you a few hundred bucks, okay? So I just cut pieces of this stuff. Yeah, it's not perfect. You can do a better job than I can, I promise. And then I've got layers for the firearm. Then I can layer it if I need to put another firearm in here. Okay, two or three layers of that. And I can put my magazines, or I can put another firearm, or whatever I want to do. Or I can put three or four, depending on how I want to configure this little case. It's great. It locks up. It's a great way to protect your firearms, and it's inexpensive.
I really do love this weather. I'm actually standing out with a metal pole at the end of my cell phone in a thunderstorm right now. I don't know how bright that is, but I will tell you that I do love this weather. It's rainy in West Texas. Reminds me of Scotland. I love Scotland. I don't look like the guy from the grass commercial. Feed it! Feed your lawn! At all, right? Actually, I'm not wearing my kilt today, as you can see. I'm wearing my jeans, but I am known for wearing a kilt occasionally, which totally embarrasses my daughter. And that's part of the reason that I do it. So we're going to be talking with her coming up in just a little bit. Meredith stops by the All-American Radio Show.
I know, we need a job for Meredith, and I'm Spencer, and this is Gunner. Hi, Gunner.
I'm available for labor.
Hey, you know what? He's a great furniture mover, too, and we're going to find out what these guys think about stuff in the world.
We're the midget and the giant of the shop.
Yes. So, let's see. You, Meredith, how tall are you?
5 foot.
5 foot. Gunner?
6'6 or 6'7, I can't remember.
Yeah.
He's not done growing.
No.
Evidently not.
And I was
pity the bull that has to feed that poor boy. There you go.
Yeah. A lot of money.
All right, guys. You're typical teens, young people. I shouldn't say teens. You're in your 20s now.
Yeah.
I know. How has time has flown, Mayor? I want to talk about politics right now.
Oh.
That's always a touchy subject.
It is.
Is it a touchy subject? I mean, do you talk to your friends about politics? Are they?
Well, no. Everyone I know is not voting for Hillary.
Right.
I don't have any friends that are voting for Hillary. I don't really have a choice. I kind of have to vote for Trump because he's the only Republican that we have, but I want Ben Carson.
I know. I saw that today on your post. You like Ben Carson to come back?
Yes.
Okay.
Very much so.
Gunner, how about you? What do you think? If you don't mind me asking.
Besides, I think these things need to go away.
It's a Hiller tree. A Hiller tree.
Yeah.
Oh my God, run away!
Like, I think the only real person that I ever really talked to with politics is my best friend Boomer, who I've known since 7th grade. And we're both, of course, I mean, he has to vote for Trump as well, Republican. But me personally, I'm not entirely sure. In my personal opinion, it's kind of a lose-lose either way this year. There's a lot of things that Trump says that I agree with, a lot of things that I don't, and that goes for with anybody. I mean, obviously you're gonna not fully agree with everybody 100% of the time. If it was, we'd be a utopia. But of course, one man's utopia, another man's dystopia, and all that, it's another topic altogether. But in my opinion, whoever we get, I respect the fact that they are in the position to do so, not me, considering I'm just an everyman. They have the qualifications to do such. I do not, so of course, hats off to them either way. But by the same token, I do hope that they follow through and uphold the Constitution, withhold the rights, and make sure that everybody is, you know, treated equal. I mean, that's my biggest thing, is equality. Whether it's race, religion, anything like that, I respect everybody as long as you respect me. So that's kind of how I stand on it. There's not anybody I'm really rooting for that I'm gung-ho about winning, but, I mean,
I have an idea of, like, maybe who you supported before this, if you don't mind me asking.
Not at all.
Who was it?
I honestly couldn't tell you.
You didn't have a pick before?
Not Ted Cruz, Ben Carson.
I was kind of going for Ted Cruz.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously just because Texas. But besides that, I mean, you know, I've always been very open-minded to everything. I'm willing to listen to every argument. I'm willing to sit there and have a, you know, an intelligent conversation, not at all an argument. I'm willing to sit there and talk intellectually about anything that you can bring up, but...
Well, that brings another question. Is there anybody that you can have a discussion with these days? Because go on Facebook and or Twitter, and it's like a landmine. You talk about something, and all of a sudden, I mean, people are pretty polarized right now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I like to go for the person who's not... Who doesn't put the American lives at risk, mm-hmm. who cares about our military, that cares about our police.
Exactly.
That is what I stand for. You stand for our police. You stand for the people who take care of you and are upholding the Constitution. You want to break the laws and stuff hits the fan. You brought that upon yourself, and that's the way I look at it. I'm going to follow through with whoever upholds where I can the right to bear arms. They love our military, and I know that's one thing I do appreciate about Trump,
mm-hmm.
is that he supports our military and he supports our police, and that is the main reason that I feel so strongly I'm voting for Trump and not Hillary. Hillary is an idiot, mm-hmm. and that's not just my personal opinion. She shows it when she laughs about, on Snapchat messages, we can delete these just like I deleted those emails. She laughs about it, and American lives were put at stake. So that's why I can't stand her. I just
okay,
like
well,
her.
Let's get to happier subjects, guys.
Let's do that.
So what are the happy subjects that you, I mean, what makes
Guns.
You happy? Guns?
Guns make me happy.
Guns make you happy.
Guns make everyone happy.
Right.
Unless you're a liberal.
Yeah. Shots fired.
Trigger!
Right? Let's go. I don't know. Things that make me happy.
Rain.
Yeah.
I love the rain.
I do enjoy the weather we're having, so that's a good change of pace. Wish we got more of it, but I'll take what I can get, especially around West Texas.
Right. Favorite movies? Did you go see Suicide Squad?
I saw Suicide Squad, and it might be a little bit adult, but I went and saw Sausage Party as well.
Oh, there you go. What do you think?
It was hilarious. I enjoy it. I recommend anybody who has not seen it yet to go watch it. Don't bring your children. It's not an animated show for them. It's for us.
Please don't bring your children to Sausage Party.
Older audiences only.
I mean, this should be a given. Oh, honey, let's go to bring the kids to a sausage party.
That's a talk waiting to happen.
Yeah, we haven't had that talk yet, by the way. Okay, so what movies are you looking forward to?
I'm actually looking forward to go and see Hell or High Water.
Okay.
I saw a couple trailers about it. Don't know much about it, but just the whole Western vibe and the fact.
Midland's mentioned.
Yeah. I can't wait. Every
they
time
filmed
I go.
It New Mexico. I mean, because it's ugly out here. I'm sorry, but now it's green. It's not bad.
Give us a chance.
Yeah.
Just put a little makeup on us. We're fine.
Yeah.
But
every girl in Midland. Oh.
Ooh.
Oh.
I enjoy.
Wait a second.
Oh no. I enjoy going to see like movies that involve anything southern, because I like to see the stereotypes that they throw into it.
All right. So how about a Southern Rogue One?
Ooh.
I just watch a lot of Redbox movies. I don't have cable.
Yeah, there's not a movie
just
on
like
Redbox.
Just like the Netflix and chill kind of thing going on.
I don't even have internet and no chill, Dad. Don't be weird.
Okay. Sorry. Wow.
That happened.
I've stepped over the line here.
That's okay. You just mark it and then
hey,
mark where
your feet are. I said sausage a while ago in front of my daughter, so
it's
okay.
It's all good. Every now and then it's going to happen.
Sorry. All right. So what else? What kind of gun, Joe? No, I'm just kidding. Don't tell me because it's a surprise.
Glocks.
Okay. And...
I actually
brand name.
I don't own any right now.
Oh,
all of mine got stripped.
They got stripped.
I've never really personally owned one. I used to have an old 22 that my granddad gave me, but I've been waiting. I've been saving up because I want something custom.
Okay, sounds good. How about you?
I'm ready for you to buy me a Tavor.
Oh, sheesh. Okay, wrong subject. You. Guys, thanks. Appreciate you stopping by and putting up with your dad, Mare. You're great. Gunner, thank you. You guys have a great day.
My best friend. Come see us.
I just want to take a minute and tell you about this great cause started by my friend Gary Kennedy. He's going to be having a cook-off to help raise awareness of PTSD and what our veterans are going through and to keep them from choosing suicide. It's not an option. It can't be an option for our veterans. And he's so passionate about them and helping them that I want to help him get the word out. First annual Heart Cook-Off is going to be taking place at the Field House on October 1st. The event is looking for people to put their teams together. It's going to be 4 days long. They're going to be cook-offs, $25 for 1 day. For 4 days, it's just $75. They're looking for teams to cook brisket, chicken, you name it, even desserts. They're looking for items for a raffle and a drawing. Volunteers would be helpful too, so if you have a heart for that, they could sure use your help. Also, names and addresses of first responders so that we can give them a personal invitation. If you need more information, you can contact my buddy Gary at 432-230-9078 or 432-682-2636. It's the first annual Heart Cook-Off coming up October 1st. I hope you'll be a part of it. And that does it for this week's All-American Radio Show. I'm your host, Spencer Bennett. Thanks to Meredith, my daughter, for coming out, Gunner, Israel, and of course, Gary Kennedy, with his great event to support veterans. Don't forget to show your support for the Dallas and Dart police officers' families. We're going to give you one more look at that event that's coming up if you missed it earlier. And I hope you have a great week. If you'd like to find out more or maybe have us publicize an event, let us know. Drop us a line right here. There you go. And we'll see you next time on the Spencer Bennett All-American Radio Show. Have a great week.